Welcome, everybody. Thank you for coming back after the break. My name is Anu Agarwal, as Christy said, and I am part of the Dynamics 365 research and development, the product team, so coming up with product roadmap. And I also work very closely with partners, mostly strategic partners, to fill white spaces in our application. And Christy say that I'm from Redmond. I'm actually not. I'm from San Francisco. And it was interesting because I had a long flight over, and Monday morning I'm kind of rubbing my eyes on the cab from the airport here, and I see this bridge, and I was like, oh no, did I make it out here? Am I still in San Francisco? It was just beautiful, though. It was beautiful to see that and see something that looks very familiar to me, and then arrive here and see all the partners that I've made relationships with over the past 3 years at events like this and other events. So it's been a really great week so far, and I'm looking forward to the next 2 days focusing on the customer portion of this event, which is the first time for Extreme, as you guys all know. Really exposing you to our product and our product roadmap, and also having you build the relationships with some of our key partners that are here sponsoring. So I'm going to kind of pick up where Bill left off from this morning and go a little bit deeper in the product and how our product is enabling this idea of digital transformation that we're hoping our partners can really take to the market with our customers, and our customers can embody this within your organizations. So when it comes to engaging our customers, we do think traditionally in the customer relationship management space, but we really feel like an organization, no matter where you are in your organization, you should be very customer focused. So from an employee perspective, have the tools in place to be able to service your customers, to sell to your customers, and market to them appropriately after they've already come on board. Transforming your products, so not thinking in a product-centric world anymore, now thinking of really selling a service, because that's what we're moving to. Even traditional products are not being sold the same way. They're being bundled along with services, and everything is moving from product to subscription-centric model. And so how can you use our applications to really transform your own products into services that you provide and no longer have a one-time transaction with a customer, but build a relationship with them over time? And finally, of course, optimizing your operations. It doesn't matter what kind of cool products you've created, if you're not able to still deliver them and service them when the customer is expecting them, it doesn't matter. So you really have to tie in your operations to those new products that you're selling, to those new capabilities that you're giving to your customers. So what does this mean from a high-level Microsoft Business Cloud platform perspective? it really means that we're looking differently at in our products. First, we're standardizing everything on the Azure platform, and by doing that, we can really build these bridges and connections, not only between our Microsoft products, but also with our third-party business applications. And we're delivering all of these applications through Microsoft AppSource, and I'll talk a little bit more about AppSource toward the end of the presentation on how you can use AppSource to enhance your capabilities. So from an investment perspective, we're investing in the cloud across the board. So from productivity, our base applications, this has been our bread and butter at Microsoft, as you know, for a long time, our Office 365 suite of applications, and enhancing those capabilities. Okay. Right. Thank you. If it happens again, I'm going to pretend like it's part of my presentation. And then, of course, going into our business application platform, which is Dynamics 365, and I'm going to go a little bit deeper than what Bill did this morning and talking about our capabilities in Dynamics 365. But none of this would be we wouldn't have the capability to build any of our products on Dynamics 365 without having the platform behind it. So the innovation platform, which is Azure, not just a data platform, but a platform to be able to build and deliver applications. The data and intelligence that we're embedding into Dynamics, and this is something that I'm really excited about. I started in the CRM world where it was all about accounts, contacts, opportunities, and just linking these entities together. Now it's about having those links be built automatically using intelligence. And we have brought a lot of that Cortana intelligence into our Dynamics properties, and you'll see some examples of that. But of course, when you think about cloud, the number one thing that customers worry about is security and management of their information in the cloud. So we've invested big time, both when it comes to a mobility perspective. You have your business data in your phone, and if you're anything like me, you're leaving your phone every which place. And you want to be able to definitely wipe all of that business data off that phone through these security features, and also anything that's delivered on the cloud needs to be delivered in a secure manner. So we're going to talk now about these four pillars of our investment. And these four pillars go across the board in all of our Dynamics 365 applications. And you'll see that as we go through the demos. But the first one is that each of these are now purpose-built. So it used to be we would give you our CRM product, and you would have these boxes across the top, sales, service, marketing. And you would go in, and it was just overwhelming for our customers and users to go in there and figure out how to use this application with all of those entities exposed. So now we have built these as applications, piecemeal applications that serve a particular purpose. And they allow you to look at the business as a whole and implement things that bridge the silos together. So it's no longer customer management or operations, it's a business process that you're trying to solve for. But that also allows us to let customers start and at their own pace, to implement one of those business processes and then expand to others. We talk about this big dream of digital transformation, but we never go into a customer and the customer is ready to do that across the board, across their customers, employees, operations at one time. It's always they want to implement one piece of it, and really transforming these products to be purpose-built has allowed us to do that. So the first example is the prospect to cash. So this has typically been a very disjointed process. CRM would take you from the lead maybe to the opportunity and the quote, or the opportunity would get converted to a quote in a back-end ERP system, and then the rest of the process is completed in the ERP system. We have built it so that these two things really come together. So when you're working on a quote, or multiple quotes for a customer, you can easily convert that quote to an order, and the salesperson can see the status of the order regardless of which application they're using. Another example of a purpose-built application is our new field service application. And this allows you to really go through the process of diagnosing a problem, dispatching an engineer, making a repair at the facility, and then also invoicing the customer. And usually this happens in multiple systems, but the information is there for everyone. So the diagnosis information will go out to the mobile engineer that's out there on his mobile device, so he knows all the interactions that have happened with the customer when diagnosing the problem, and he can go and serve that customer. He can make sure that he's got the inventory he needs in his truck when he arrives at the site. There's nothing more frustrating than having somebody show up not having the parts that they need to fix the problem. He's got the mobile device that's got all of the information he needs, and we're able to use a partner to do a piece of the customer communications. So that was one of the big things in field service, is the customer not knowing, having these windows of time that, okay, the agent's going to show up to your house between 9 and 1 p.m. and just waiting for the customer. We've integrated a third party so that the customer themselves can see where the field agent is, know exactly when they're going to show up at the property to come fix the problem. But our goal, though, is to reduce that process as we get more of these connected devices into our homes and our businesses and be able to diagnose those problems and even fix those problems remotely, be able to reset a device remotely. And the only way that we can enable this is to use Azure IoT to bring in all that high volume information and be able to see, say, when a device is not functioning the way it's supposed to. And so we've enabled this connected field service out-of-the-box solution that enables IoT and allows you to remotely fix things. And then if that's not, if that doesn't happen, then be able to dispatch the agent anyway using our field service capabilities to go fix it on site. And I know there's a workshop here when it comes to IoT that would be a really interesting one to check out, really forward-looking scenarios. And then finally, we've built a whole suite of capabilities around project service, another purpose-built application that allows you to scope a project, assign the resources, plan and schedule the project, allows when the project is in process, the engineers that are working on the project to enter their time and expenses and materials, and finally create an invoice for the customer for that particular project that consists maybe of some fixed assets, some products that are fixed pricing, and then also some variable pricing, like the time that the engineer is spending on the project. So this whole process can be handled by our new project service application. So even though we're building these purpose-built applications, of course, the biggest challenge is still getting users to use them. So what we've done is built a gamification engine, which makes it fun to use those applications and rewards the users for using those applications. So I'm going to play a short video that shows you how this works.
Microsoft Dynamics 365 gamification turns work into play by letting employees team up to collaborate and compete in fun, engaging competitions. Gamifying sales and service pays off. Employees are motivated to perform their best for themselves and for their teams, leading to increased organizational performance, productivity, and adoption of business applications. Set up a new game in minutes. Choose from various sports themes that everyone can get excited about: football, racing, soccer, and many more. Keep employees in the game longer with metrics and points based on activities they can control. 5 points for every call made. 10 points for every case resolved. Level the playing field by assigning employees to positions. Prizes can be anything, recognition or monetary. Multiple prizes equals more winners and longer participation. Scoring the games is a cinch with out-of-the-box integration with Dynamics 365. Award points, badges, and trophies throughout the game. Track results on leaderboards. Make results highly visible. Showcase your top employees by streaming results and rankings to big screens across the office or call center. See performance take off when employees team up to collaborate and compete by drafting their own teams. Even non-players can get into the game by drafting teams or rooting for teams. With Microsoft Dynamics 365 gamification, work has never been so much fun. Coming soon to AppSource.
That last part actually is a little bit dated. This application is already on AppSource for you to go out and check it out. Really powerful about this engine is that it can run across our properties, so you can gamify your sales, your service, your marketing, even your project and field service operations, and you can even bring third-party data into this engine. So any behavior you want to encourage in your users, you can through the gamification engine. So now we're going to switch gears a little bit and talk about how we have introduced productivity into our applications. A lot of this is what we just released recently. We have created more intuitive application experiences with our integration, increasing our integration with Office 365. Office 365 integration has really been our key differentiator since we started coming out with our CRM, what we typically call our CRM product. And we've continued to innovate in Office 365 because we're noticing that users, no matter what applications we put out there, no matter how many games we introduce for those applications, users are still spending a lot of time within Outlook. So let's make them more productive within that Outlook environment and have them be introduced to those tools within Outlook so that they want to go back and use the fully functional tools within the Dynamics 365. And finally, our mobile applications. We want that to be a familiar application across all the mobile devices. So first thing I'm going to talk about is our Outlook web application. We've enhanced the user interface for that application. We've enhanced the capabilities around resolving who the recipient is, being able to recognize the recipient based on the email address, based on the account that they're coming from. Making processes like tracking very intuitive, one-click tracking of an email and associating it with the appropriate contact or opportunity within the back-end system. And then being able to compose emails using templates. So within that Dynamics 365 application that's showing up in Outlook, you can even compose emails and send them out through Outlook.
Microsoft Dynamics 365 app for Outlook helps you boost your productivity by displaying Dynamics 365 data within the familiar Outlook app. When you receive a new email message, you can see all the Dynamics 365 related information, whether you're using Outlook for the desktop, the Outlook web app included with Office 365, or the Outlook mobile app. Track and set the regarding record with one click. You can also track and set the regarding record for appointments. You can track records for any built-in entity or for your own custom entity. It's simple to add activities to Dynamics 365, such as tasks, phone calls, or appointments. When you compose a message, view Dynamics 365 data about the recipients. To save time for frequently sent messages, add an email template from Dynamics 365. You can also add sales literature or KB articles. And by using the Dynamics 365 add-in, you can now track your Outlook contacts in Dynamics 365 and link them to a Dynamics 365 account. This ability to track and link your Outlook contacts is a unique feature introduced in the December 2016 update for Dynamics 365. To learn more about the exciting new capabilities in Dynamics 365 app for Outlook, please visit our website.
Yeah, so if you've seen older versions of our Outlook integration, this is just completely revamped the user experience when you see that side panel and only the information you need in that side panel. And the way the UI really meshes with the Office 365 UI is something that we've been working a lot on and are really proud of. Process automation. So you saw a little bit of this in Carson's demo earlier today, but we have enhanced our business process engine. So this is the ability to create business processes for each entity or each process that you're trying to solve for. What we've done to enhance is it made it easier to create and modify those business processes because we've heard from our customers that every customer is a little bit different on how they want to handle these business processes, which steps they want to be required, which fields they want to be required, what the triggers are to move on to the next step in the business process. So we've created this designer interface to make it really easy to create those business processes and roll them out to your users. And we've also found that this business process is a very iterative process. And we've added some tools to allow you to see which business processes are being used, which stages your users are getting stuck in, so you can enhance those stages or tweak those stages a little bit so that the users can be more productive and get past those stages, and even launch multiple business processes to solve the same problem at the same time to see which ones are working better and roll out those in an iterative way. And finally, we've really enhanced our resource scheduling engine. So when we first thought about resource scheduling, it was in the context of our field service, managing our field service resources. And then we saw that a lot of those field service resources in many organizations are the same resources that are involved in project. So we brought those two scheduling engines for field service and project service together under one resource scheduling engine. And what we found, though, is that a scheduling engine can be generic. It doesn't have to be based on people as resources. And we could expand that to include things like meeting rooms, for example. A meeting room for this event, being able to schedule each session in this event into a certain meeting room for certain blocks of time. That whole process, and then being able to book the sleeping rooms also, it's kind of a similar thing. You have a certain set of resources, and you want to schedule things into that resources based on availability, based on the setup you want for the room, based on certain characteristics. So we've expanded this engine so that you can schedule basically anything. It's not just about scheduling people anymore or materials, but basically any kind of resource can be scheduled using this generic resource scheduling engine. We've also introduced relevant search. So this is another area where we utilize the power of Azure to be able to search across the board. So we've incorporated Azure search within Dynamics 365. So you can search across any entity because it's all indexed using the Azure engine. And you can also search within documents. So that was something we didn't have before, the capability to search within any document attachments and then see those entities that have been searched on, see the categorization for them on the left-hand side and be able to drill in and easily find the information. Search is an area that's super important across the board. It doesn't matter if you're using email or web search. We found that search is a really important capability, and so we've invested a lot of time in enhancing this relevant search to make it easy for users to find the information that they need to get to. All right, so now we're going to talk about intelligence, and I'm smiling because this is my most favorite area to talk about because for me, no matter how purpose-built or productive I can be, to get the system to do things for me, that's is just amazing. I'm kind of a lazy person like that. But when that information doesn't have to be entered into CRM manually by me, I don't have to track things manually, I get all the intelligence I want. All I need to do is open my application in the morning and it's kind of telling me what I need to take care of for the day. To me, that is really going beyond your traditional CRM system and going to an intelligent customer engagement system. So we're going to talk about it in three ways, the way we have built in artificial intelligence into Dynamics 365, and then I'm going to talk about a little bit more about the customer insights application, that platform that we have built that Bill kind of introduced you to. We'll go a little bit deeper on that and a customer example, how a customer has used that platform that we just came out with in the fall, and then we'll talk a little bit about our social engagement platform and how we've enhanced it with intelligence capabilities. So all of these intelligence examples, we got kind of a head start because we already had this Cortana Intelligence suite of applications that we could use. So what we did is we have worked very closely with the Cortana Intelligence team and asked them to build out these machine learning algorithms. In our Dynamics 365 team, we don't really have data scientists or anything like that. We leverage all of the assets from Cortana to bring this intelligence into Dynamics 365. So it ranges all the way from relationship insights to a lead scoring engine, preemptive service, our resource optimization. All of these capabilities we're just leveraging from Cortana, which also gives you the ability to look at those machine learning algorithms in Cortana, see how they're built and leveraged, and build your own or get a partner to build some of the intelligence that would be specific to your business. So let's go a little bit deeper on relationship insights. This is one of the newer capabilities, and it basically allows you to assess the health of your relationship. And what it uses is the information from your Outlook or Exchange, so all the emails that you've been exchanging with a particular account or a customer at the account. and it will and the data within CRM. So all of the activities that you're tracking in CRM. So it's bringing both of those together, and it's giving you a quick glimpse of what that relationship looks like. And the capabilities include email engagement, auto capture, and relationship insights. I'll talk about each one of those. So email engagement is the ability to track an email and also to schedule emails over time. So putting an email into the system and sending that email out at a later time, and also sending out reminders to you to if an email hasn't been opened. The second part of it is to be able to see what's going on with that email. So for example, when the email has been opened, if there are attachments in the email, has the recipient opened those attachments? Have they replied? Have they forwarded that email to other people in the organization? Auto capture is an intelligent way to bring those emails into Dynamics and automatically within the particular entity, and then be able to just one-click track each of those emails. And the final part of Relationship Insights is the Relationship Assistant. And this is not only giving you exposure to what the health is of that relationship, but giving you intelligent suggestions on what to do next. So for example, in this one, that there's an opportunity that's closing in 2 weeks, you better look at that opportunity, open it up, see, make sure that you're on the right track to close that opportunity. Or there's a meeting request. It will tell you that based on that meeting request that you're getting from this customer, based on the relationship health, whether you need to address that, have that meeting today, or if it's something that can wait because it's progressing smoothly based on all of the other factors in your system. Now let's talk about this transformational intelligence platform. So some of the Azure ML that we've incorporated in CRM, it kind of followed this path. It looked at the data in Dynamics 365, build intelligence around that data, and then give you some actual insight that you could take. We're taking this now to the next level, where you can get data from multiple different systems and combine that into one platform. And this makes the system a lot more powerful in what it can do, because it's not only looking at your email and your Dynamics 365 engagement, but it's looking across the board, even in third-party systems, for that intelligence. And there's really only one way to build a system that does this. And it is to leverage Azure and the intelligence suite. The reason why is because a lot of that data is going to be high volume, high scale data. We're talking about data from a kiosk. We're talking about data from mobile devices, web data, surfing, all of that information. It's at scale, so it needs to go into a system like Azure. So we've built that, and we've modeled business entities on top of that data, created some business process analytics, and then allow customers and partners to build applications on top of that data. Marston's is one of those customers that has done that. And they've really taken that suite and they've connected it with their most important applications, getting their most important data out and building intelligence and some apps around it. So let's watch a short video to see how they've done that.
Cortana Intelligence Customer Insights empowers businesses to get closer to their customers in more helpful, proactive, and natural ways. Businesses are trying to understand what their customers think about their brand and how they can keep customers engaged with their products. Let's take a look at how Marston's, a restaurant chain, uses customer intelligence to better manage their customer relationships. The management team at Marston's wants to discover some critical information about their customers, like, what menu items are the best sellers? What do our customers think about us? Who's coming and how long are they staying? How can we improve the dining experience? For companies to get started with customer intelligence, they first need to provide a customer insights hub within Azure. To make this easy, we've templatized the hub creation process based on industry. For Marston's, select the hospitality industry and then name your hub, enter a region, select your Azure subscription, then connect your Dynamics 365 instance to extract and populate your customer data within the hub. Since we are using the hospitality template, the model solution will populate customer profile data from Dynamics 365, as well as the restaurant data in the account entities.
In the case of Marston's, they also have data about table reservations, customer surveys and satisfaction, Wi-Fi logs, voucher redemptions, and more. This customer data is accumulated over time from the point of sale, wireless activity, surveys, and reservations, which all connect to the Customer Insights Hub we just created. You can also define KPIs and then, with a simple design tool, put together printable views about customers for the restaurant waitstaff. Let's look at an example. For Natalie, a Marston's customer, the restaurant staff can quickly see contact information that was generated from the online reservation tool and her past service satisfaction with Marston's restaurants. We can also see Natalie's journey in a timeline view that highlights every touch point with the customer, like bookings, Wi-Fi logins, point of sale info, and surveys Natalie has taken. By selecting the brand view, we can see how a brand manager or marketer can get valuable information to help with initiating campaigns and customer outreach. Not only do we see aggregated gender and age demographics, but also when they frequent the restaurant. The manager can view the satisfaction index that is broken down into categories, so they know what areas to focus on improving. By selecting the restaurant view, a restaurant manager or owner can get a snapshot of how the restaurants are performing. We can see the monthly revenue, reservation source, and other key insights to help owners make better operations and business decisions. Cortana Customer Intelligence Insights can also be viewed inside Microsoft Dynamics 365. This enables customer service reps to better service the customer and marketers to have more informative engagements.
So just to review kind of what Marston's did is they took all of that data from all these disparate systems and put it into Azure Customer Intelligence System to really derive some of these KPIs, like what is the satisfaction level, what is the lifetime value. And then they were able to do this to build applications that are tailored for their users. Be able to look at those insights. So they could look overall at their performance. The house manager has a specific applications that gives him metrics. The restaurant manager themselves can look at the metrics and look at that individual user and see what the importance of that customer is over the lifetime. And then even the server has his own application to be able to better serve that customer. So imagine all these loyalty systems that we've been exposed to, all these 10 different loyalty cards that we keep. Imagine those all coming together and the business, when you approach them, they really know who you are across all of these programs and they can better service you. That's what we're trying to get to with customer insights, really a 360 view of that customer. That's been kind of a pipe dream for a long time for many organizations. Microsoft Social Engagement. So our core capabilities when we built Microsoft Social Engagement was really to solve a customer service problem, which was when social media kind of proliferated, everything became about posting, and what companies were finding is people are more likely to post a negative feedback, and they wanted to be able to respond to those intelligently, pull those out of the system based on kind of the importance of that user, how many followers he has, and that's what we built our social engagement product part of, to be able to do that listening and then be able to capture those into service requests and respond to the ones that are most important. And build analytics across that to see how you're doing across these social channels. We've enhanced these capabilities recently. Before we used to have the ability to tag specific posts. Now we can tag specific authors so that we can respond to them more intelligently. We also built the capabilities to automatically tag, so looking at the text of the social media post and being able to read that and automatically tag it. And finally, being able to see some statistics across that automation. So that's what we're finding. We build these machine learning algorithms, these things to do automatically, but we're finding that users really need to get a glance into whether that algorithm is working or if it needs to be tweaked a little bit or how smart it has gotten. Because of course, all of these machine learning algorithms are only as smart as all the data that's being fed into them over time. So you can get to a point where you can see that your tagging is really happening accurately when it's happening automatically, or it's not quite ready yet, so you do need to review them before you have those tags finalized. We've also incorporated social selling. So moving away from social being just about customer service and responding to a tweet that's about a bad customer experience to also be about social selling. So finding the right tweets that look like there are leads and opportunities and having the salesperson engage with that person over the social media platform that other people are looking at too. Once they see, okay, looks like you had this customer service issue, but now you're interested in another product, responding on that platform and getting out to a wide audience through social selling. We've incorporated the capability to look at an entire conversation within our social engagement property, and we're broadening the scope of what we're listening to include other social media. All right, so now let's switch gears a little bit and talk about how this platform, all of these capabilities that we've built are really adaptable towards your business. You saw a little bit earlier this morning how Carson was showing you the application designer. So we've built these purpose-built applications from sales all the way to project service. But the idea here is to open this up and allow you to build your own applications that have the entities that you want to expose using this graphical designer. We've also introduced the idea of grids within the application. Originally, you were able to enter your data within Excel and then have to import it in. And then we had an embedded Excel experience, and now we have a grid experience where you don't have to use Excel, but you can still get that same grid experience for data entry. And finally, we've introduced learning path for administrators. This was a capability that we originally had for users, but now we have it for administrators as well. And we'll watch a short video on how that works.
The Learning Path Designer, which is open to partners and customers, lets you create in-app guidance that is contextual, role-based, and available right on the page where your people are working to help you train and onboard your organization efficiently. It's a fun way to build people skills. When a user signs in, Learning Path presents quick tours, guided tasks with instructional bubbles, and sidebars that slide in with links to videos, articles, and downloadable content. The designer lets you build this content tailored for your organization, so you can leverage training materials or web content you've already created and surface it within the app. Here's how the designer works. Access to the content authoring experience is controlled with a security privilege. Anyone with a security privilege has access to the designer and can see the content library and create bubbles and sidebars. The content library gives you an all-up view of all of your guided tasks and sidebars, which you can sort, filter, and search. Click Edit to open a sidebar to type the text. The WYSIWYG editor lets you include different types of content: YouTube video, text, external links, and even links to other Learning Path tours, guided tasks, or sidebars, so you can create an end-to-end content experience. For guided tasks, the flow editor lets you drag and drop to add steps or bubbles. You can type text into bubbles, and bubbles can include links to embedded video content, so you can play videos inside the app right inside a bubble. When you're ready, you can use drag and drop to pin each bubble to a UI element. The designer lets you know which elements you can pin to. As you go, you can preview your work so you can see how it looks. And when it looks good, you can publish, either individually right then within the tool, or you can publish several guided tasks and sidebars at once from the content library. Publishing gives you lots of flexibility. You can publish to one or more organizations, and you can also create your content in a sandbox environment and then publish to production without a lot of effort. The Learning Path Designer is a powerful tool to help you create contextual, role-aware, custom guidance to onboard and train users of your Dynamics 365 organization.
So again, Learning Path is a really cool way, after you create these custom built applications, to be able to train your users on them without having a formalized training. They just get that in-app guidance, they can watch a video, and they know exactly how to use the application. Our data export service is something that came directly out of customer feedback. The ability to be able to manipulate that data that's in CRM online and bring it to Azure SQL database and use Excel or Power BI to create dashboards and visualizations on top of that data. So this is also something new that we introduced very recently. So I'm going to talk a little bit about common data services. You might have been hearing this word, but this is really the platform where we're combining all of the data from all of our different systems. So Dynamics 365 data combined with the Office 365 data, and then even with partner data, it can all be brought into our common data services platform, which then can be used, as Bill had talked about earlier this morning, to build Power Apps or to build Microsoft Flow applications on top of. We have separate sessions in the next 2 days on these two capabilities, so please attend them if you want to get more information. Power Apps basically gives you the ability to create applications on top of that data or on top of third-party data without writing any code, and then publish those applications on various devices. Flow allows you to send information between different systems based on triggers. So in this example, like when a tweet is logged, check certain characteristics. If they meet, go into the Dynamics system, create a record, and then maybe launch a marketing campaign. So now I want to talk a little bit about our third-party business applications and how we are extending them through AppSource. As we introduce these capabilities, we've really seen our ecosystem grow. And you can see this even with Extreme, how much it has grown from the days of where it was maybe 100 people in a room to, I think we had 700 this week. The ecosystem has really grown and really enhanced our application platform, all of these partners overall. So one that I want to talk about in particular that has worked very closely with our development team is Cafe X, and they have provided this capability for omnichannel communication. So let's watch the video and see what we mean by that.
In today's connected world, the customer experience is becoming a key brand differentiator. With so many communication channels available, do you know which one has the highest customer satisfaction levels? Surveys show that it's live chat followed by voice. With Live Assist for Microsoft Dynamics 365 powered by Cafe X, agents can chat, co-browse, and have voice and video calls with their customers to resolve issues faster. Let's look at live chat and co-browse. Lisa is an agent who's already signed in to Unified Service Desk for Dynamics 365. On the left, you see Dynamics 365 dashboards, and on the right is the Live Assist agent chat window. Nancy is a customer requesting a live chat. She provides her name in the pre-check questionnaire, and Lisa grabs the chat from the queue. She sees the chat context and Nancy's name. Because there's already a record for Nancy in Dynamics 365, her contact info and related cases are available. Lisa sends a message to Nancy, and now Nancy knows she's chatting with Lisa. With the knowledge management option here, Lisa can search for articles to help Nancy and send an article directly to her in the chat session window. If the article doesn't address Nancy's concern, Lisa can start a co-browse session to help further. The co-browse window opens for Lisa, and when prompted, Nancy clicks the accept button to provide consent. Now Lisa can see Nancy's portal page in the co-browse window. She can use annotations to show Nancy things she's talking about and browse to other helpful pages on Nancy's behalf. Now Nancy has a different question on installation. Lisa's not an expert in that area, so she looks for an available agent who is and finds Amy. Lisa transfers the request to Amy, and then Lisa's agent chat session closes. Let's look at how it works for Amy after the transfer. From Dynamics 365, Amy sees she has a chat request and clicks it to open the chat session window. Because this is a transfer from Lisa's chat with Nancy, Amy can see the entire conversation between Nancy and Lisa.
Hey, So that is one of those ways that you can engage your customers, working side by side with them to resolve the issue. I also want to talk about another partner of ours called Versium, and they are in the predictive analytics space, and they have been in this space for a while. So while we have our own embedded capabilities with Cortana, we know that some of our partners have been enhancing their own data science, their own machine learning algorithms over time, so we've decided to incorporate them as well. So let's look at what you can do with Versium.
Microsoft has partnered with Versium to bring you Predict, a predictive analytics suite inside Dynamics 365. Now, sales and marketing professionals using Dynamics 365 can use Predict with business or consumer data to score leads and contacts, generate new leads from Versium's data warehouse, and enrich existing contact data. Let me start by showing you how to score leads using a predictive model. For step one, select the marketing list you want to score. For step two, select the predictive model that you want to use to score your leads. For step three, confirm your previous selections. Select whether to save the scores back into your marketing list in the CRM. When you're ready, click Begin Scoring to start scoring your leads. Once the scoring process begins, you are taken to the predictive lead score dashboard. When the scoring has completed, you can see a summary of how the leads scored against your predictive model. The new scores are saved back to their respective records in Dynamics 365 and can be used to create new marketing lists. Now, let me show you how to generate a new list of leads from Versium's data warehouse using a predictive model. In step one, choose your list type. In step two, select the predictive model you want to use. In step three, you'll select your geotype and target area. You can now see how many leads are available once you select the geo. In step four, give your new list a name and select how many leads you want in the list. For step five, just confirm your selections and make sure that the Add to CRM box is checked. This will automatically save your new list of leads back to Dynamics 365 as a new marketing list. Once you're ready, click Begin Building List to start processing. You will now be taken to the Built List dashboard. Predict builds your predictive list from leads in the Versium data warehouse that score highly according to the model that is used. These are brand new, highly targeted leads that you didn't have before. The new generated list is now saved back to Dynamics 365 as a new list of leads. This level of integration adds predictive analytics and lead generation directly in your existing Dynamics 365 workflow. Adding new insights to the data you already have in Dynamics is just as easy. For step one, select the type of insights you would like to add. For step two, select the marketing list you would like to add insights to. For step three, confirm your selections. When ready, click Add Insights to start processing your list. You'll now be taken to the Data Insights dashboard. As with lead scoring and list generation, the added insights can also be saved back to Dynamics 365. Just choose what data you want to save and if you want to overwrite or just fill in the gaps. Predict also offers new insights at a record level using Data Finder. If you look up a lead, contact, or account, scroll down to the Data Finder section to see new insights such as business contact data and firmographics, as well as consumer contact data and demographics when available. With Predict by Versium, you now have the power of predictive intelligence for sales and marketing directly inside Microsoft Dynamics 365.
So all of these capabilities are included in our Microsoft App Source, which we launched about seven to eight months ago now. App Source has now 400 applications, and what's really amazing about this is each of these applications are certified by Microsoft. So we work hand in hand with a partner to make sure that their application is working alongside our Business Cloud platform. And these apps cover across our properties. There's some are for Dynamics 365, Power BI, Office 365, across the board. And we've seen that this app source thing that just started out as a way for us to get ISV solutions to customers and partners has really provided benefits across our ecosystem. For the customers to be able to find and try these applications, the providers of the applications to get them out in front of more customers, for our integration partners to be able to enhance customer offerings over the life cycle of the customer. No longer are they introducing Dynamics 365, but they're engaging with a customer along their journey to introduce these applications and finding them as they come up on AppSource. And finally, for Microsoft, as more of these applications get used, it only increases the value of your investment. So I just want to wrap up by saying thank you. Thank you for being here, both to our customers and our partners that have been here all week, and to the Extreme team to make this possible for us to build these relationships with each other. Thank you.
Thank you, Anu.